Hello, I'm Jeanine Cummins. This is my new novel, American Dirt, and I'm going to read a short extract. The first time a head turned up by itself on the street in Acapulco, it was a big deal. It was a 22-year-old head, with curly black hair shaved close on the sides and left long on top. It had a small gold hoop earring in its right ear. Its eyelids swelled and its tongue protruded from its mouth. It was left on top of a public phone booth outside Pizza Hut, right next to the Diana Cazadora fountain. Rolled up and stuck into the corner of its mouth like a cigarette was a note that read, "Me gusta hablar," I like to talk. The woman who found the head as she walked home from her shift as a night nurse at the Hospital del Pacifico was not a woman ordinarily horror-struck by the sight of blood. But that day, just as dawn tipped its westerly light across the pavements of Acapulco, causing the head to throw its queer bodiless shadow from atop the phone booth and toward the feet of the weary nurse, she screamed, dropped her purse, and ran three blocks before retrieving her phone from her pocket and calling the police. The officers descended, the media swarmed. People passing through the area on their way to work or school were aghast. They took the time to get down on their knees and bless themselves, to offer up some thorough prayers on behalf of the anonymous soul who had once belonged to that head. It was famous until the second one. By the time the head count reached a dozen, a shameful self-protective apathy began to spread in the gut of the city, so that in the mornings when a call would come in that a head had been found, on the beach or at El Zócalo or on the green of the ninth hole at El Club de Golf, the dispatcher answering the phone would sometimes make a joke. "Go for the putter. That hole is an easy par three." Back then, Sebastian had been the first one to recognize it for what it was, the city's steep wholesale descent into the maw of the warring cartels. While other journalists were reluctant to acquiesce to the truth of their collapsing reality, Sebastian shouted it from his headlines. "Cartels exhibit brutal surge in violence. Terror and impunity, cartels get away with murder." And most dramatically, after a particularly bad weekend, which saw the murders of two journalists, a city councilwoman, three shopkeepers, two bus drivers, a priest, an accountant, and a child holding a cob of buttered corn on the beach, his sandy feet still damp from the ocean, a simple pronouncement in 2-inch letters, "Acapulco Falls."